Doc Poche, which was sitting about 4 or 5 rows down below us. I noticed the man starting to go down a little bit, and so I went over there and grabbed him and laid him on the ground, and Doc checked him immediately for a pulse and see if he was breathing. He didn't have either one. And Doc started administering chest compression. I started doing the breath for him and tried to get the medics over as quick as we could, and I guess we worked on him. Seems like forever. It's probably 3 to 5 minutes, maybe 7, somewhere up in there. And by the time the paramedics got there, we had him back breathing in with a pulse, and he left on the stretch reports going to the hospital. And what we get today is he's fine, doing well in the hospital. So,
and you said you did knock him out?
Yes.
Had a firefighter check on
that? Yes, I'm a fireman, and this is a veteran. Paid off. We've done CPR hundreds of times. That's the first time I've ever had to do mouth to mouth, but everything worked out. You know, in the end, it worked out great.
And it occurred in the sixth inning.
In the sixth inning, I missed that. We missed the plans, this home run. We were just about finishing up when the home run was hit.
And about how long was the whole sequence of events?
I'm going to say 5 to 7 minutes, probably.
Have you received much attention today?
Too much. Honestly, I did what I would hope anybody else would do. You know, your instincts, your reactions just take over, and just trying to help the guy who was in trouble. Way too much attention for what I did, I can tell you.
Anything you want to add?
No, I just hope he's back for a game 3 tomorrow night. Maybe the man can make it back. I don't even know.